you know, you're fighting at UFC 112, and you got some good momentum going now. You're on a 4-fight winning streak, and this is your first fight on the main card. How do you feel about that?
Yeah, I'm obviously confident coming off 4 wins, but you know, I'm not really thinking about them 4 wins now. I've got to think about April the 10th, and I've got to think about Rafael Dos Anjos. You know, he's a very tough opponent. I think many people underrate him as well. I think if you actually watch his fights and you do history on him, he is, you know, his grappling skills are very, very good, and also his stand-up, you know. So I'm not taking it lightly, and I'm expecting a very hard fight.
Guy like UFC commentator Joe Rogan, he's compared you to a lightweight Anderson Silva. Do you think that Rafael's going to have anything for you on the feet?
Yeah, I mean, always in MMA, you can't underestimate someone, you know. You've got them little gloves on, so if anyone gets caught with them gloves on, you know, it can be the end of the fight for you. But, I mean, I do think I hold advantage on the feet, but not to say that he hasn't got nothing standing for himself, you know. I've seen one of his fights against Rob Emerson, and he absolutely destroyed Rob Emerson standing up, and Rob Emerson was supposed to be the striker in that fight, so, you know, you can never say that in MMA, but as you say, I do think I have got the advantage on the people. I think he is a good striker himself.
When you hear things like he's a lightweight Anderson Silva, and you've just been moved up to the main card and you've got this momentum going, do you feel any increased like pressure or weight of expectation? Does it affect you at all in any way?
No, I mean, it is nice to get compared to the likes of Anderson Silva and people like that, but I don't try and let things like that go to your head, you know. You've got to just take that as a throwaway comment and just concentrate on your training and concentrate on your fight. I think if you do listen to things like that, you know, go to your head, and you end up getting beaten in your fights, you know. So I think I've got like the right team now. Colin just says to me, look, don't listen to any of the hype, you know, never believe your own hype. You've got to be training harder than every other time you train, and keep on winning fights, and that's the main thing.
So you're gonna be fighting overseas. You fought in America before.
Yeah.
Abu Dhabi's slightly different climate. It's going to be outdoors as well, possibly. Do you think that presents any new challenges?
Yeah, I think, obviously, the climate's going to be different, but I think with it going out early, we're obviously going out early for a reason, and that's to get used to the climate out there, so I don't think it's going to be too big of a difference. I think it's going to be interesting to see what the actual show's going to be like out there, what the atmosphere's going to be like. Obviously, over here in America, the fans are absolutely bouncing, and hopefully the fans out there are the same. We'll see when we're out there.
You've got Calvin's got like a very strong Thai boxing base,
yeah.
But in the grappling thing, you're slightly unusual to a lot of UK gyms because you're training Luta Livre rather than Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu.
Yeah.
Does that add anything different?
I mean, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and Luta Livre are quite similar, you know. Obviously, there's little things that are different, but I mean, as you see, lots of our fighters have got a strong Thai boxing base, but you see many of our wins are by submission, you know. In my own career, 10 or 11 of my wins have been by submission, so it's not like we're lacking at all on the ground. We've got one of the best ground coaches about, you know, Marcelo Brigadier, so it's not a problem.
When you look at, there's a fellow Brit, Dan Hardy,
yeah,
and he's been kind of fast-tracked into a title shot. He's had 4 wins as well, and he's been bumped right up the ranking. When you look at that, do you feel like, do you wish you'd have been kind of fast-tracked like that as well, or are you happy to have been kind of built slowly?
No, you know, I mean, obviously Dan has been fast-tracked, and you know, he's done very well in his last few fights. He's absolutely flying, and he's on fire at the moment, and I think he does deserve to be where he's at. You know, he's just going to beat Mike Swick, who everyone considered to be one of the number one contenders. So when you beat guys like that, you know, you deserve to be where you're at, and hopefully on Saturday you can come home with the belt. I think it'd be great for British MMA as a whole. I think it shows how big that British MMA is getting. You know, we've got Dan Hardy fighting for the belt, and there's a whole bunch of other young English fighters who are coming through as well, so it's great.
What do you think about the lightweight title fight on your card, UFC 112?
Edgar against BJ. Yeah, I think Edgar's going to have his arm full, but I mean, obviously anything can happen. It's MMA, and we've seen it happen many times before. Edgar of late's been flying, but I think he's going to be in for a very, very tough fight against BJ. You know, BJ's something else, and I think after watching him against Diego Sanchez and what he's done to Diego Sanchez and stuff like that, I think he proved at the moment he's on a bit of a different level, but not to say that Edgar can't take the fight.
You think if you get past this fight yourself, they'll start looking at putting you into matches like that, maybe sort of fringes of title contender matches.
You know what, I don't even think about stuff like that. As you always say, I just take each fight as it comes in. The main fight on my mind now is Rafael Dos Anjos. I don't want to think past him. As I said, he's a very tough opponent, so you can't start looking past fighters and looking to next fights. I'll take this fight, hopefully win this fight, and then we'll take it from there.